aside old-style fun and games. For us millennials, it's all about hashtag being connected all the time. Phone apps, social media sites, online gaming, posts, shares, likes, tweets, the list goes on and on. Technology is our middle name, but there is such a thing as overexposure. One of those moments where parents are actually right. So while we enjoy our freedom, let's also keep an eye on the serious dangers lurking in the vast web of communication. It sounds scary, but with just a few rules, it's easy and safe to harness the madness. Rule number one, do not accept requests from unknown people. The first thing your mommy has taught you since you were little, don't talk to strangers. The same rule applies online. Unknown online entities posing as friends may want to chat with you or share emails. But just hold on for a second and think why an unknown person would suddenly want to be friends with you. Come what may, do not share your personal information until and unless you are sure about the person. And never ever, ever meet up with them in real life. Ever. This may turn out to be a personal security issue if the person has bad intent. Rule number two, be mindful of photo sharing. It's the age of Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, WhatsApp, and YouTube. Publishing posts, pictures, or videos is the language we millennials talk in. After all, who wouldn't want to be the coolest person of millennial town? But always remember to keep your privacy setting to only share with friends. You do not want the whole world to know your every move. Also remember, putting up loads of your personal information on the internet can turn into an invitation for negative entities to use and, more importantly, misuse it. Wondering how? Hundreds of ways exist, like creating fake online accounts, using your name and face for illegal activities like pornographic sites and fake money transactions. All of this using your identity and ultimately getting you in serious trouble. So, moral of the story? Share responsibly, whether it's your own or someone else's picture. Rule number three, beware of cyberbullies. When our parents were kids, bullies only roamed in school corridors. Well, today, they are also on our computers and phones. Cyberbullies are all those sullen, nasty, faceless guys who will take offense to even a simple post and use abusive, offensive language to put you down. So what do you do? Do not be afraid of them. Think of them as anger-spewing machines that can do you no harm. Block them, report them to parents, teachers, your elder sibling, with whosoever you're comfortable with, and stay away for good. Every mobile app or social media app has an easy-to-operate feature for reporting cyberbullies, after which it's the company's job to take action. Save yourself and others from any incident. Remember, cyberbullies, like most bullies, vanish when ignored. Rule number four, think carefully before sharing explicit content. Just like in the real world, in the virtual world too, there are all kinds of people, including serious perverts. But the good news is that they are easy to spot. Anyone who sends you explicit photos or messages, wants to share indecent pictures or videos, or asks you for pictures that you wouldn't even want your parent to see, is an online perv and must be reported at once. You never know where a picture or video you shared just for fun finally ends up. And you definitely don't want your friends, family, parents, or even teachers seeing your face and body on distasteful sites. Rule number five, safeguard your social apps. Enable two-factor authentication. Enable notification and select right alerts. Configure privacy policy. Only share with friends while sharing any information. So those were a few rules to keeping yourself safe from the hazards of too much internet. Let's be honest now. The online world is our playground, but every playground has some rules. So come on, guys. Follow the rules, play fair, and play safe.